Match photo is a feature that allows you to match your model to a photograph in either SketchUp Pro or previously in SketchUp Make. So what you do is you drag these vanishing point bars to match reference lines in the photograph that you know should be 90 degrees to each other. Or in other words, lines that you know should be aligned to the green and red axis. So what you're trying to do is align the axis in the model to an imaginary axis in the photograph. And once you've done that, then you just scale the model up to match the size of the photograph. And essentially what you've done is you've matched the location and perspective of the camera in SketchUp to the location and perspective of the camera that actually took the photograph. So this allows you to do a couple of things. You can either create a model from scratch by simply referencing what you see in the photo, or you can match an existing model to an existing structure in the photo. And then from there, you can export an image directly from SketchUp, or you can export just parts of the model to create a composition in an external program like Photoshop or something like that. Now, creating a match photo can be really confusing. A lot of times when you initiate a match photo, it is just a complete mess. And in this video, I'm going to share a few tips that I use to make your life a lot easier when creating a match photo. Hey, I'm Matt from MasterSketchUp.com, author of SketchUp to Layout and co-author of SketchUp and Layout for Architecture. Now, match photo really depends on having a good photo to start with. So let's take a look at a few examples so you can see what makes a good photo for match photo. Now, in this example, what you're looking for are lines that you can reference in the photo that you know align to either the red or green axis. So in this example, the siding makes an excellent reference line, the edge of the roof, the top of the roof, and then on the adjacent wall, we can align to the siding for the green axis. Now you can use match photo for interiors as well, and notice how the perspective of this photo was taken so that you can clearly see both of these walls. So if we look at some reference lines that we might align to, we can grab maybe the back of the counter, the front of the counter down here. We have all these different lines that we know should be 90 degrees aligned to the green or red axis. And the same thing with this interior photo. We have all these different lines. These are just examples. And, you know, they don't even have to be, like, you could align to maybe a joint on the wood floor, for instance. Or if you have drop ceiling, you might be able to catch some lines there. Some important things to look for is to have the lines be as long as possible. I mean, you could still do short lines, but the longer they are, the more accurate you're gonna be. You also want to have a wide range between the lines. So in this example, you know, we're grabbing high up at the ceiling and then down low way at the floor. And this will create a very accurate match photo. Now, another thing to keep in mind is the match photo has a reference grid feature that will help you align two planes that are in the photograph while you're adjusting the vanishing point bars. So there's one of three configurations that you can choose from for the reference grid. So for something like a building, you would want to choose the outside reference grid configuration. And what that does is it creates this grid along one of three planes. So the red blue plane, the green blue plane, and the red green plane. Now you have full control. You can turn these on and off if you just want to see one or the other. You can also turn it to auto, where it will only appear at when you're actually adjusting these vanishing point bars. So you might want to do that because it is kind of overwhelming when you first jump into match photo. And we're going to go step by step in just a moment here. So don't worry, don't get overwhelmed here. So when you're thinking about the perspective for the photograph you want to use, you can keep these in mind. So for instance, interior photo, where you're shooting sort of at the inside corner of a wall where you see the red plane and the green plane. Those are just things that you want to keep in mind. And it doesn't have to be perfect. You don't have to be perfectly 45 degrees looking straight at the corner, but the closer you are to that, the easier it's going to be. So these are things to just keep in mind when you're selecting your photo. All right, so let's go ahead and open up a new SketchUp file, and we're gonna walk through step-by-step how to create a matched photo. All right, so we have our SketchUp file here, and actually, before we start the match photo, we want to look at the photo we're going to use. So we're going to do this shed here. And if you want to download this photo and the file that we're using in this video, there will be a link to that in the description below. So this step is really important. Most people skip this step, and I feel like this makes your life so much easier when you're using match photo. And that is to analyze the photo and decide where you want the origin to start. I don't care if you're building a model from scratch based off of the reference photo, or you're matching an existing model. I think this is really important. So what I mean by this is you want to decide which two planes you are going to align the reference grid to. And in this case, it's rather obvious because we have, you know, just a cube. So it's going to be this face and this face. And you want to keep in mind the different grid styles that are offered. If you're doing an interior, you're going to want to use this grid style. If you're doing an exterior, you'll want to use this one. This is an outside corner. This one in the middle is also an outside corner, but it's kind of looking from above. So if you're using satellite image or drone footage or something like that, you would want to use this one. So what you want to do is think about where this point is going to be. So where is that outside corner? Where is that origin going to be? And that's going to be the intersection of the ground and then those two planes. So we want our origin to be right here at this bottom corner. Okay, so now that we know where that origin exists, we're going to go into SketchUp and we're going to orbit the camera so that the axes are aligned roughly to what they should be in the photo. So we know that the green axis is over here. This is the origin. The red axis runs off this way. So in SketchUp, something like this is going to be roughly matching the camera perspective. We're trying to get it just as close, you know, just roughly close to what the camera perspective is. And then you want to create some reference geometry in SketchUp. It doesn't have to be dimensionally accurate, although if you do know the dimensions of anything in the photograph, that is going to be extremely helpful, because when you're doing a match photo, you need to scale the model to match the photo. So if you have something that you can refer to in order to match that size to the size of the photo, that's going to make your life a lot easier. So in this case, I know that from the ground up to the bottom of the soffit is 8 feet. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to delete this guy here. I'm going to tap R for the rectangle tool. And right at the origin, I'm going to start. I'm going to create a rectangle. I don't know the dimensions here, so that doesn't matter. But the height I know is going to be 8 feet. So with the push-pull tool, just tap P for push-pull. And I'm going to tap in 8 feet, enter. And now I have some sort of reference geometry in the model that I can use. And then I'll just triple click this and make a group just so that geometry is contained in the group. Now, keep in mind, if you're working in an existing model, you can always use the axis tool to realign your axis to any point in the model. So you would basically do the same thing here, but instead of drawing it from the origin, you would just move the origin to where you need it to be and make sure the axes are aligned appropriately to how the grid reference is going to be drawn. All right, so to recap, we have our camera roughly located where we want it. We have the origin right at that bottom corner that we know in the match photo we're going to have it snap to. And now we're ready to create the match photo. All right, so we're going to go up to camera, match new photo. We're going to select the photo we want and click open. And now SketchUp has jumped into match photo mode. Now automatically the match photo panel will expand. This is where you can choose how you want the grid to be displayed. So you just want to make sure that whatever configuration your photo is, you have the correct reference grid style selected. So since we're doing an outside corner, we're going to just activate this one here. And the first thing you're going to do is you're going to click and drag the origin to match the point in the photo that we previously identified. You're going to see why this is important a little bit later on when we scale the model. Now, if you find this to be a little overwhelming, like if you have a lot in your model, you can disable this model checkbox and it'll hide the model for you so you can just focus on the vanishing point bars. You can also toggle the grid to auto. That way the grid doesn't appear unless you're actually actively dragging one of the vanishing point bars. So all we're going to do, I'm going to just turn the model on. That way you can kind of see the effect as you drag the points. You can see what happens to the model. So what you're going to do, you can just click and drag along any of the bar to drag the entire thing, or you can click and drag one of the endpoints, and that'll allow you to position the endpoint. So I'm going to go down to the bottom here and I'm going to drag this to that point. And then I'm going to find that line and drag the other point to that line. So you're just looking for the reference lines in the photograph that you can align the vanishing point bars to. So I'll align to the roof edge here, and then with my green vanishing point bar, I'll grab that, align that to the siding there, and then the last one, and you can already see the grid, how it's getting very close to being aligned. We're already pretty close. And then once I get this final tweak in here, we'll get pretty good. Now you'll notice that the box that I drew, it's kind of hard to see, but this is the box that I drew. And remember, this is our 8 foot mark, you know, from here up to here is 8 feet. And by the way, the reference grid, you can change the spacing. So right now I have it set to 1 foot. I could change that to 5 feet or whatever. So I'll just leave it to 1 foot. So once you have the vanishing point bars aligned to the reference lines in the model, you're gonna just hover over one of the axes. So if you hover over the blue axis, you'll see the double arrow indicator, and you can click and drag, and that's gonna scale the model to match whatever is in the photo. So the reason why it was important to have a common origin point in the model is because when you're scaling, everything scales away from that origin. So if you have a common point in the photo and a common point in the model that you know is going to be the origin, when you scale, it makes it that much easier because now you're just scaling in one direction. So like if you had the origin in a different location, then you'd have to, you know, as you scale, everything's gonna be moving away. So you'd have to like scale, move, and it just makes it a little bit harder. So this makes it a lot easier to scale the model once you have finished. And once you have gotten everything to the way you like it, you just click done and you now have the match photo. All right, so once the match photo is created, you'll notice that a scene is added to the SketchUp model. So you can actually orbit around and that'll jump out of the match photo. But if you ever want to go back to that view, you can just double click on the tab or go over to your scenes panel and you'll see the scene right there that you can jump into. So if I were to, you know, in this situation, maybe I'm trying to, you know, model this shed by referencing the photo. So there's a few things you can do directly from this view in order to model while still being able to view the photo. So what I like to do is use the scale tool. So if I jump inside of this group and select everything, grab the scale tool, and then turn on hidden geometry. So if you go to view, hidden, you wanna go to X-ray view. So now you can kind of see everything. You can see all the handles behind there and you can grab those handles and scale that box without having to leave the view of the photograph. But then there are obviously times where you'll need to orbit around and kind of go to the other side to view what you're working on. But using the scale tool and hidden geometry is kind of a helpful tip when you're wanting to model while still viewing the photograph. Now, you can always go back and edit a match photo at any time under the match photo panel by clicking this gear icon, and you'll jump right back inside of that view where you can change any of these handles to further configure the match photo. Now, as a side note, there's this feature that you can project the textures of the photo onto your model. So if you click this button and then jump outside of the match photo, you can see how that picture is actually projected right on the model. So I did this kind of quick, so it's not perfect, but you get the idea how you could kind of create a model and then project those textures right on it so you don't have to model all of these details. All right, so let's take a look at another example. So in this interior bathroom, I don't have a good origin point at the floor, but I do have a good intersection of these three planes up at the top of the ceiling. So what I could do in SketchUp is create this reference geometry that just has the three planes intersecting. And since this is where I want my origin to be, I just need to move my axis up to that point. So I could select all of this and drop it down, but I also want to show you how the axis tool works. So you just grab the axis tool, you click at the origin, and then you can slide the axis to wherever you want. So you just align the red axis and then you align the green axis, and now your origin has been moved. Now remember, axes, location and orientation is something that gets saved in the scene. So when the match photo is created, that axis location will be saved there. But if you have other scenes where the axis is located, you know, in the original position, you don't have to worry about that, you know, changing because you just changed it here. So the other thing I did here is I added two guides, and what these are the distance between the countertop and the ceiling. So that is a dimension that I know, it's 53 inches. So I measured that and I'm going to use that as a reference in the match photo. So then I'll go ahead and create the new match photo. So the first thing I want to do is move the origin up to where the origin is in the photo. And, you know, sometimes the model kind of gets in the way, so I'll just turn that off. And then all I need to do is grab these handles, align them to edges in the photo. And actually, I forgot to switch the grid style. So this is an inside corner. Even though this is technically the ground in this example, I'm just gonna, you know, that works totally fine. That works totally fine. So we can then drag this. And now when I bring the model back, I'm going to use this reference line, the tape measure guide that I created, to align with the countertop. And then I'm done. So then I can grab this medicine cabinet and slide it over into position. And then I can hide that temporary geometry that we created. And we can now see what this medicine cabinet looks like in the photo. All right, that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you learned a few things on how to more easily create a match photo. If you are not a subscriber to this channel, please consider subscribing. I do a lot of SketchUp tutorials, and if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, and I will see you in the next video.